Hey guys, your boy Crippers, and welcome back to my FIFA 17 Liverpool Grammo, where last time after off we began and the journey in the Champions League for season 4. In this episode, going into a game against Watford in the League Cup, and there will be a Premier League game as well. Well, but first up is indeed the game against the Hornets. That's their nickname, isn't it? I always get confused by Watford's nickname. It's cup tie time. Well, good to be called the Hornets, but why is their badge a moose?
The supporters as we came into the stadium.
I mean,
the game today, Liverpool.
You're going to be called the Hornets. Wouldn't it make more sense to have a hornet on your
one at home against Bournemouth?
Yeah, impressive.
For badge? No.
I think that's going to be enough to carry them through here.
If I'm thinking of a different team, maybe I am. I don't know why. I just can't help think it is Watford.
It could be the star turn for Liverpool today.
The Hornets. I don't know why.
Martin and his teammates will be anxious to feed him that ball as much as they can.
There's a lot of those, isn't there?
Our referee is Darren Bolt.
I think
we're ready to go.
I think even their mascot is up for.
Well, there's a lot of good players out there, but they don't always show it in this competition.
It's called Harry the Hornet or something like that. Again, I might be thinking of a completely different team. I don't know. I think it's Watford. Any Watford fans watching me, please excuse my lack of knowledge of your club. If I'm thinking of a different club, I apologize. This is. If you are called the Hornets, why is there a moose on your badge? Surely, it would make more sense to have a hornet. Now, I don't know. I don't know a lot about Watford. In fact, I know next to nothing about it. I don't even know where Watford is. I really don't. To be honest, I couldn't care less.
He's got to it, and he's claimed the ball too.
If I could care, I would probably look it up, but yeah. Care.
Good interception. Good challenge here.
Well, this attack, yeah, whatever.
Got a bit of menace to it. Now he can cross it. Played into the middle. Keeper might be needed again. He didn't hang on to the ball.
That's a free kick, no? Hello? That's a free kick! Deeney. Oh, piss off.
What a grafter this fellow is for his team.
I think it's the first.
It's a quick break. And shoots!
Hey!
It's been a very
for being denied a clear free kick.
That really their football has suggested would come.
Costa Pereira scores.
Regretting those misses, but now they've opened the scoring, and you would feel that they'll go on and win from here.
From a follow.
Well, the goalkeeper
shot at following cross from Moya.
Well, it was an easy goal in the end. The kind that you wouldn't expect to get at this level.
Good.
So the first goal, it's 1-0. Mario Suarez. And in he goes with the tackle. Now they've got a chance in this part of the pitch.
Oh, yeah.
Chippy! Got
Rembergen 2-0.
It's a big moment for them in the match. They've
get in.
Now to two ahead. They played well to
this. Things are going well.
Sometimes a two-goal lead can be a dangerous one. We'll see. Very much quick-fire football from these boys. They've scored again. Another angle on it here.
I mean, that 2-0 lead will give me a good advantage for the rest of this game.
Mario Suarez.
Dini for what?
Some potential in this move.
Come on, get the ball off of him.
Patience.
What's the point of having a tackle button if when I press it, they don't fucking tackle?
If you look at the coaching manual,
just stand there like you're brain dead.
Square to his man there, Paul.
That's always the good, best solution.
Tackle goes in. That's great defending there, stopping that attack. Etienne Capoue. Terrific tackle.
Pereira.
Onto the attack now.
Where?
The break is definitely on.
Avoids the and mostly
come off the goalkeeper, hey. Still in play.
Mercy her.
Caught under no challenge by the goalkeeper.
Maybe I should hit it. Maybe I should.
That's a great interception.
Shoulda, woulda, coulda.
Advantage. I think any football fan would say when the rain. Oh, he's through.
Will Baltimore.
He slid in there with
I was more sorry.
Little private game between the two of them.
You're going to have to not play those two together. Getting the two who mix up because their names are so similar. Ooh. Stinger of a shot. That was familiar.
And it's out now for a goal kick.
God's sake. Really, Ojo? Really? That's what you do. You hear it
in this performance.
I don't know if he mis-headered it and he accidentally headered it out. Maybe it crossed the line regardless. I don't know. It looked like it was his fault. It's, not good. Not good.
Etienne Capoue. And it's going to be a minimum of 3 minutes to be played of added time.
Beautiful ball from Moya. Can I get the third goal here?
Danger to the opposition now they're here.
Straight against Kabul. Brilliant.
Half time now.
2-0 half time. Ah.
Good action in the English League Cup in the first 45 minutes. Second half starts now.
Yeah, I think one or two players surprised us actually how well they played in that first half. They'd be delighted.
I thought it would switch me over when they passed. That's this game is really boiling my blood.
It's a quick break.
Moya. Yes. Oh, you've got it.
Corner.
This third goal. No. Don't worry. Give absolute the worst lost header
poor touch.
Or towards goal I've ever seen in my life.
Pretty easy to defend against.
And that will equal profit.
Makes the challenge
as it rolls harmlessly into the arms of the keeper. It's not parried away, it's not spilled for an attacker to pounce on, it's just picked up and whatever, that attack's over.
Maldini. Mario Suarez.
We've had an hour gone here, and still 30 minutes left.
Trying to switch on the attacking power in this situation.
Ojo, come on. Next to no one is up here. Huh? Where's my attack? Did I go fucking park the bus when I wasn't paying attention?
Liverpool have won a corner.
For
you on EA Sports, don't forget, don't miss this, the coverage of the Premier League fixture.
Liverpool, they'll be facing Swansea City away from home.
Please don't.
Look forward to joining you in the gantry for it.
I'm still unbalanced. No idea why everyone is hanging back when I'm on a fucking run.
Stopping that attack.
That makes zero sense. It should be my two strikers. I'm playing with two strikers, and neither are waiting for a cross into the box. No one's running, giving a supporting run. And when I make a run down the wings with the ball, oh, they're only they're from corners and throw-ins and free kicks. Do my players not know how to play the game that they are paid to play professionally? Because it seems like they don't.
And he could get away here. He's had a go here. That's in the back of the net.
Somehow I'm 3-0 up. Somehow, I don't know how. It's a miracle.
Seem to lose his bearings completely, Mark.
Because the players are playing like a bunch of fucking idiots.
Here, 3-0 as the game gets underway. Ighalo, 10 minutes left of regular time. 3-0 now, almost over, and this should have a good impact on the next game, Alan.
Well, Liverpool go up against Swansea City after this.
Wait, he didn't give a free kick for that.
They've played well.
He must have played the advantage
next match.
For Watford.
Comes in with a tackle.
He might go back and
pull. Ibrahim Moore. Into the attacking third.
And no, I still don't know how to pronounce his name properly. His name is too long. It is. It's too long. I wish he had a nickname. I don't know if... Wait. I might have something to look into. I don't know if I can change that anymore. If I go into edit player. I don't know if I got it. I know I bought it in the last game, but I didn't use it. So I bought it. And I got a catalog. I don't know. Can I give a player anything? I wish I could.
Well, that looked promising.
I hate he's been stopped. Calling him the freaking Danny Alves region. I mean, I would love to be able to pronounce his name, but it's just too fucking long. I mean, the Kaká region here Costa Pereira. At least his name is somewhat easy to say. Look at that. Like, I mean, I could call him Anderson. Like, that would probably be my best hope of having something to call him.
English League Cup. AFC Wimbledon 0, Stoke City 1. Bournemouth 1.
That's a possibility.
Milton Keynes Dons 0. Bradford City 1. Yep. Brighton Hove Albion 0. After extra time.
And yeah, you did see I have 3 teams now. It makes rotation a lot easier. Instead of going into every before every second team game, changing who plays in what team. Sorted. These players play in this one. And in this one, the players who aren't in that team play in this one. I might switch more, or maybe I'll put more with Sturridge and David with Moya. Maybe. I'll have a think about it. But yeah, you can see the rotation, like, that's the beauty of having so much depth. This is what Liverpool severely lack in real life. Quality depth. It's one of the many things that hopefully if we can hang on to Champions League football qualification by the top four, hopefully signs will be inbound in the summer window. I mean, Jurgen Klopp will be signing players anyway, only their quality will be much better if we have Champions League football. We won't be selling for Naki Williams for 42 fucking million. I really hope that is complete bullshit. I heard that.
Hi there, everyone. Martin Tyler here with me today.
We might be getting him. 42 million for Inaki Williams. I mean, Inaki Williams is a good player, but 42 million, we can get much better for 42 million. 42 million wouldn't buy you half of Coutinho. It wouldn't even buy you his left foot. And we're going to pay 42 million for someone who, unless there's another injury to someone like Sadio Mane in real life, will not play on a regular basis. Let's be fucking real here.
In recent games, and just one out.
If we're paying 42 million, that player needs to start every single game unless they are injured or suspended.
Oliver is the fullbacks. Dele Alli starts with Renato Sanchez in central midfield, and the strike force.
We can't be wasting money this time.
With a chance to go into the lead now.
If you tell me Inaki Williams is going to come into the Liverpool first team, I will call you a stonewall liar. No way he would. No way. He is not even close to Sadio Mane. His quality. He's okay, but he's nowhere near Mane's quality. He's not better than Firmino. He's not better than Coutinho.
In terms of goal scoring, we should.
He's not better than Origi. I wouldn't imagine he's better than Sturridge.
All areas of the pitch too.
I would much rather have Sturridge, who can barely fucking run anymore.
Today, and he's got some news for us.
It's a goal for Southampton. 15 minutes played, 1-0.
Oh, interesting news.
42 million for Naki Williams. My ass.
By the keeper. Referee is pointed for a corner.
I'll be doing a summer transfer window video. The suggestions are looked at, or maybe better. I don't know. Jurgen Klopp might have his own suggestions in his mind. His signings have been hit and miss this season. Mane's been good. Wijnaldum's been okay. Some people, people have been giving Wijnaldum a good bit of credit. He's been okay. Whenever I watched Liverpool, he's barely there. Like, in the last game.
Didn't give him much time.
In the game against West Brom.
Is now 1-0.
At the end of the game, everyone was singing Wijnaldum's name. I'm like, Wijnaldum didn't do anything. He was involved in the game barely. He did next to nothing, and you're singing his name like he won the game. No, but same Firmino's name. He scored the fucking goal. Roberto Firmino must be like Firmino
into this attack.
Going on my hey, sure I scored that goal. You're saying no one else is saying? What the fuck did he do this game? Nothing. Nothing. You. I watched the Redman TV, which is the Liverpool fan TV, and I tried to listen. Why they justified it? They said he like held on to the ball for a while. What? That, what? No. Unless he does something with the ball, you don't see his name. Just because he held on to the ball. Any idiot can do that. I mean, don't get me wrong, when Alan's had a few good games, he's had a few bad games. He's been mix and match, you know, it's a bit like his season last season with Newcastle. He's good 1 week, then he's terrible the next week. Like, he went on a bit of a run, then he's freaking a shadow. And I don't mean that in a racist sense. This point, I mean, as in, you barely notice him, or you just don't notice him at all.
Here's Alan.
Like,
good interception.
You barely notice he's there.
Attacking now.
You're like, well, now.
Tackle here.
I even said, build up until get to my front when we were watching the game. Him.
Home team him. Have some work to do, Alan, because they've lost their last two games.
In fact, he said it. He said, everyone had been, you know, okay in that first half, except for Wijnaldum. He said he didn't even see him. Is Wijnaldum even playing? We have to check.
Real go.
Well, you can't knock him. He was in the right
for sure. Like, to our surprise, he was in fact on the pitch. He did fuck all. And yet, at the end of the game, the fans were singing his name. It baffled me. It really did. Like. If I were Firmino, that would piss me off. That would rightly piss me off.
Jefferson Montero.
The dude's been the best player in the last two games. Scoring the winner in both. He scored the winner against Stoke. And he scores the winner against West Brom. After the West Brom home game, Genie went out and song is being sung.
3 minutes.
You must be like
Jefferson Montero. What? Short passes.
No, Firmino. Not one of them. You're singing the wrong song there.
Fine save he's made there.
It's fucking madness.
Ball escape his grasp.
Clavin has. He had a few good games, but mostly his games have been.
That'll be a disappointment.
You look at him during some of the games he played recently.
Winning and not conceding. Like,
where is Matip and. And Dejan, where are they? I cringe anytime I see a center back partnership of Ragnar Klavan and fucking Lucas Leiva. Lucas has no business as a center back. He's a center defensive mid. He's the only one we have. I don't count Chen because what? He never fucking defends. He's an out now centerman. Okay, let's just put that to bed. Like the only other player who kind of plays that role is Jordan Henderson, who's injured again and again and again. How many times is that guy gonna get injured?
It's been scored by
Does he have a fucking hospital loyalty card just like Daniel Sturridge seems?
Slot the ball home. 52 minutes.
Seriously, the injury bug left Daniel Sturridge alone. Well, mostly this season, and it fucking picked on Jordan Henderson. It's like, oh, Jordan Henderson, I'll go for him next. Is it attracted to English players by any chance?
Well, could be,
you know, this is a bit of a trend. You know?
Sadio Mane almost stealthily into scoring position here, not picked up.
Anyone else knows that? Anyone else? No, nope, just me. Okay.
You don't get away with
yeah.
A
Mane, of course,
no, Russia blood.
Best player this season. Well, one of the best players, I have to give Coutinho and Firmino have been unreal. Some players have had good games. You know, our players have been hit and miss. Firmino, Coutinho, and Mane. When they're in the form, they're really good.
So finally, the stalemate is broken.
Coutinho was out of form for a bit, but now his form has really turned on its head.
Just a little nudge to nudge you in the direction.
He even dropped some weight. He's doing
coverage of the Premier League fixture.
Swansea everyone says they do in the New Year. I'll lose some weight.
Get excited.
Better at my work. As well. Coutinho, he actually did that.
Imminent for Swansea City.
Coutinho is better than all of us.
And that will be Liverpool's throw-in.
I was going to say we should all be ashamed. There's no shame.
Alan McAnally with a goal to tell us about from Aston Villa's game.
And Firmino, again, he had a few games where he was quiet, but most of the season he's been inconsistent.
This is an
With Mane out, Firmino is probably going to end up top goal scorer unless he gets injured or we just don't score any more goals this season, which are both very likely, considering how Liverpool's season has gone. Joe Matip, whenever he plays, I just like,
some progress.
We got you on a free. How is that a thing? Seriously.
What about Liverpool's?
We should have paid 30 plus mil for
it's the goalkeeper's ball.
Matip. We got him on a free.
Quick out the blocks.
That must piss off a lot of Premier League teams. Like, there must have been teams looking at us like, I bet Arsenal were sick to their stomach. They paid so much money for Mustafi, and Liverpool are here getting a player for just as good, if not better, than Mustafi. I don't say that as a biased Liverpool fan. Matip has had a better season than Mustafi. I think even Arsenal fans would probably say that. Mustafi's not had the best first season in an Arsenal shirt. Matip, you wouldn't think this was his first season. He had a few shaky games when he was coming back from his ankle injury.
Here and lift the home team.
Yeah, I think they believe.
Because of course he was injured when we signed him. Because why the hell wouldn't he be injured? No, but
Amat moving the opposition.
He shook it off, and he two players. He has been hands down our best defensive player.
Really on top of their game now.
Like most seasons, that's not hard to do. Who? Because most seasons our defense has been terrible.
Time is against them. Here's a corner though. Try and.
But Jurgen Klopp
matter so much.
Spied a gem a with Matic.
Still just a one goal in it.
I wonder if Schalke realized what they lost. I don't know if they did.
Here's the shot. What a fine save.
If they had, I don't think Matic would be where he is. He'd still be in Germany. That's just my opinion. I don't know why Schalke let his contract.
Well done, the goalkeeper, and he's hung on.
That was clearly an oversight for some reason.
Gone for the through pass.
The fourth official has indicated there will be a minimum of.
Letting the shot go. He's kept it out.
And maybe Matip just wouldn't sign a new contract, and he wanted to leave. But surely Schalke would have gotten some money out.
Here's the chance. Great start.
Right?
Just the one goal in it.
It's really baffling.
And a chance to add to that one goal advantage. Very late in this.
Gruch has done absolutely nothing. Has he even played this season? I don't even know if he played in the cups. That's how little he's done this season. So, hard to assess someone you barely can see play. Like, even when he's on the bench, and we're like, okay, you're going to bring on a central midfielder. No, brings on a defender or a striker. Or he brings on Alexander Arnold and Ben Woodburn.
They proved
when two Very misguided. And no offense to Ben Woodburn, Trent Alexander Arnold. They are fantastic players with the potential of being superstars one day. If they reach their potential, I think they are stars in the making. Again, that could just come off as, you know, I'm a Liverpool fan, so of course I would think that. No, I genuinely think they are fantastic players.
Aston Villa, there's Arsenal,
Liverpool,
one.
Oh, bias aside.
City, 3, Newcastle United,
one.
Southampton, 2, Norwich City, 0.
Think what you will.
Stoke City, 2, Manchester United, 1. Swansea City, 0, Liverpool, 1. Watford, 1, Tottenham Hotspur, 1. West Bromwich Albion, 0, Chelsea, 1.
I feel like I'm forgetting some.
For the league tables. At the top of
the Karius! Liverpool with 18 points. That's who I was forgetting. Karius. That's why he's so forgettable.
Aston Villa with 11 points.
When
in fourth, Manchester City with
bring
in
a new keeper in fifth, to replace one who is playing terrible.
In sixth, Tottenham Hotspur.
And it gets to a point where that keeper that you brought in is replaced in goal by the keeper he was supposed to replace, and that keeper suddenly starts playing unreal.
Second bottom, Norwich City.
You're like, 3 points. What parallel dimension have I stepped into?
3 points.
Some, Mignolet has probably been the best keeper in the Premier League in the last two games. Listen to what I said very carefully. The last two games. He was good against... Yeah, man of match performance against Stoke. And he pulled off a crucial save against West Brom. And like, you look at him and you think, is this the same Mignolet? Have I been transported to a parallel dimension of some description? You honestly think, what the hell is going on? Oh, there's a surprise. 93-94. Yeah, that explains why he's so quick. But, yeah. So, you can expect that video. I'll probably do it after the season's over. And I can, like, do it. And they review the season. So, yeah. Probably reiterate some more of those points and talk about some other players as well. Anyway, that will have to wait for another day. Hey, until the next episode, thanks for watching. I'm Joy. Smash the like button if you did. Subscribe if you're new. And then until next time, I hope you all have a very, very nice day. Peace.